Well, I was born in Mount Pleasant. We're not too far from here, maybe 30, 35 miles, I don't know exactly. And then was raised in a small town between Mount Pleasant and Big Rapids. And really, with my family life and a small high school that we went to, college at that time, just what I graduated in 1968, wasn't a big deal with a lot of families in our area. It was more optional than anything. Sports was. So I played basketball, football, and baseball, and that was my life in high school years. Plus, we all had to work, you know, because we were working families, so we all had jobs at gas stations or grocery stores or delivering fuel oil like I did on weekends to farmers and things. Well, all of a sudden, college did become serious to me, maybe this last half of my senior year, and realized that with my grades, you know, there wasn't a lot of options. So I applied to Ferris and got in, and I think at that time, I didn't have enough math, so I think we were on quarters then, and so I think we had to take an earlier math class and kind of on probation. I don't remember what they called it, but you know, to get the grade. And away I went, and fell in love with it. Had to learn how to study, had to learn how to take notes, had to the whole thing from scratch, because again, in high school, that's just not what we did. So I got a two-year degree from Ferris in the 70s, early, I think 1970 or 71, and had to go to work. I just ran out of money, you know. There was no college loans or things like that. So there was an interview day at Oldsmobile in engineering, and there was a whole bunch of students from all around engineering schools applying for this one job. And I remember waiting in the lobby as kids went in and out to be interviewed. For the engineering, it was kind of an engineering apprenticeship kind of thing, and all I had is a two-year degree from Ferris, and there were 4.0 students from Michigan State, and I just thought I wouldn't have a chance for this job, but I got it. Fast forward 12 years to now, and I came back to Ferris, sat in classrooms, took all the online classes I could get so I could get my four-year degree. I just thought that was something I always wanted to do, so it took a lot of years to get that, but I did finish that here at Ferris. I was very proud to do that. I learned at Ferris, and that's really one of the key things that got me volunteering so much at Ferris, is that it is for everybody. It gives everybody a chance. Sure, there's people that come here for some of the great specific majors that are here at Ferris that are just fantastic. From, you know, I don't need to go down the list, but you know, I think the first I read at my last advisory board meeting, there was 100% placement in the top 8 schools or something like that. So it's just amazing. And so one of the top 5 things I talk about, I'll just give you this example, is that who here thinks that a apprenticeship is important? About half the kids raised their hand, because the other half maybe didn't hear me or didn't want to raise their hand because they knew I was going to, you know, what if you raise your hands, you're going to make me come down front or something. And I say, well, let me tell you that I think that's one of the top 5 things you can get out of this school. And let me tell you how, and everybody here, by the way, can have an apprenticeship, 100% of you, if you do 2 things. One is, and that's where I give them at some point in your life, you're gonna realize that you're responsible for all your actions. It's not your mom or dad or teacher or whatever, it's you. So if you do 2 things for me, I'll guarantee you 100% of you can have an apprenticeship. And like I said, I think it's one of the top 5 things you can get out of school, because you'll probably get a job through your apprenticeships or find out an industry you don't like and change majors if you work someplace for a summer. But go to Google, go to Google Patents, and put in the industry you're interested in, whether that's dental or golf or plastics or optometry or pharmacy or whatever that is. Maybe you don't want to be a pharmacist, but you want to work in a, you know, for Eli Lilly, a drug company or something, which is great. But if you put in the product or the name or the industry in Google Maps or in Google Patents, you will get thousands of hits of patents for the companies that you might be interested in, that hold patents that you might be interested in getting an internship. Well, that first page has the address and the name of the company and the name of the individual on it. So you can get Eli Lilly, Bob Smith, have a patent on this, 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 and this, and get 100 of those. And get all their phone numbers, which are easy to get on the web now, and you call them and you go, "Hi Bob, my name is Mike and I'm a student at Ferris and I'm in your major and I'm just wondering who I could talk to in your company that might help me get an internship for the summer, because I'm interested, I just read your patent." And those people are, not most of the time, not all the time, but you got 100 of them to try. If you will make 100 phone calls, you will have an internship. You will. My name is on 51 or 2 patents now, so I've never stopped that addictive inventor side of me. I currently have 5 websites selling product. I wrote a book last year called Should Your Idea Become a Business? I volunteer, of course, a lot at Ferris, but also at other colleges around the state. I have an NPR radio talk show that's once a week called Innovation Talk, where I'll bring on guests. It's just 15 minutes, but I bring on guests, we do it live, that have something to do with innovation. So 2 weeks ago, I had a patent attorney on because, as you know, all the patent laws changed this year. And what does that mean to startup companies or small companies that, you know, instead of first to think of the idea, now it's first to file, and major changes like that. But I'll bring on a packaging person or an engineering person or a marketing person or a web development person, and we'll just have we'll chat about what kinds of things that people may need help with. If you've never done it, if you've never visited Ferris or came back to Ferris and talked with people like yourself and say, you know, what can I do? They'll find something for you to do. I mean, they will. All you have to do is ask and just get online and go to the Alumni Association and, you know, ask Jeremy, trust me. Because that first step can be a little strange. You feel like, well, you know, yes, I've run this large global company, but what could I do for these students? Probably nobody. But trust me, you would be surprised. Not only will they find a niche for you to give back, but the rewards that you get, like I just said, for me are just fantastic. It helps me stay current, and you know, to volunteer at the school that you went to is, I think, not only important to give back to the community in the state, but the students from here go all over the world. I mean, you can go, I've golfed in the Caribbean and I mean all over the world, and you see Ferris alumni golf students every place. And you know, so you see that bulldog hat and you go up and you shake hands and oh yeah. So it's pretty cool. So I'd say the two things are, if you haven't tried it, give it a try. They'll find a spot for you. And the second thing is, expect more back than you give.